Hello, my name is Ethan and welcome to the channel. This is week 4 of my 2021 language progress videos, and this will be covering the 22nd through to the 28th. This week I attempted the 40-hour 7-day language challenge, and this challenge is the brainchild of Mark from Language Come Up, and I first came across it from Seabolt Speaks channel, and I'll link both of their channels down in the description. I believe the idea behind this challenge is to kind of emulate a full-time working week, so that kind of 35 to 40-hour typical working week, but instead replace it with a language of your choice. As you can probably tell from the title, I did in fact fail this challenge. I did just over 30 hours, so not quite the 40 that I was supposed to do, but I'm not too worried about that. The great thing about this challenge is that it challenges you to study more than you usually would, and that I did. I did more than twice than what I did last week. Would it have been nice to complete it? Of course, but I can always try again in a few weeks, and I most likely will. I think my biggest reason behind my failure to complete the challenge is definitely sleep, or the lack thereof. I really didn't prepare for this challenge that well. I didn't kind of get a good sleeping pattern going beforehand, and it really cost me. Last week, I could get away with it. Even if my sleeping was a bit all over the place, I was studying between 2 to 3 hours a day, and that's manageable. But once you start pushing yourself beyond what you're usually doing and what you're conditioned to do, it really takes its toll. And then during the week as well, I slept late, had to wake up early for like parcels and deliveries, and my sleeping just got kind of progressively worse throughout the week. And that really cost me. It cost me both mentally in terms of fatigue, but also physically. From about the third day, I had quite bad eye strain, and that never really recovered until the seventh day. And that's only because I kind of cut back the study. But yeah, that was kind of all on me and not a fault of the challenge. It's not all negative, and there's lots of encouraging things that I learned this week. And the main thing is that I've kind of pushed myself in terms of study stamina and just conditioning myself to actually study a bit more each day. As I said, the most I've been doing before this week is about 2 to 3 hours a day. But now I feel that I can comfortably do that kind of 4 to 6 hour range. And hopefully that means next time I do the challenge, I'll be a bit more prepared for it. If this challenge sounds like your kind of thing, I'd definitely recommend giving it a go. Even if you just want to kind of push your level a bit further, or you just have some free time. It's fun, and like I said, you can't really lose. So what did I actually study? Most of my hours went towards LingQ, so the reading application. And I did 16 hours and 24 minutes for this. Like I just said, I really built up my stamina for reading. I used to read kind of in short stints, but obviously if you want to do kind of 5 to 6 hours a day, it's a lot easier if you read in bigger chunks. At the beginning of the week, it was not easy. I could definitely feel it taking a toll, and I think this is where the eye strain came from, because you're really looking intensely at the screen for long periods of time. If you're reading in your native language, it's a little bit more relaxing, you kind of scan and skim a bit more, but this you have to really focus hard, so yeah. By the end of the week, my reading stamina really improved. I could read for a lot longer periods at a time, and I could just keep my focus. Before, it was a case of after about 20 minutes, half an hour, I kind of had to stop, have a small break, and then come back to it. But now, especially if I'm reading something that's quite engaging, it's almost like reading in English, where you just want to carry on. It's not as easy as reading in English by any stretch, but it's kind of getting to that territory in terms of conditioning and stamina. I've begun to notice a lot more patterns while I'm reading, so like prefixes and suffixes, and also I'm able to guess meanings of compound words from other words that I've known. And this obviously helps that my vocabulary's steadily increasing. And yeah, it's fun being able to kind of have a bit more of a fluidity to my reading, not having to keep stopping and starting, even if I do come across a new word. For the most part, I still need to look them up, but on occasion, it's a great feeling being able to look at a word, never have seen it before, but also being able to correctly guess the meaning. I did try to do kind of like an upper intermediate reading, where I usually stick to kind of like beginner, lower intermediate stuff. And while it was fun, it was very, very heavy in terms of new words. So it was, I just found it very descriptive. There was a lot of adjectives that I hadn't come across. And there's also a lot of jargon, surprisingly. So it's words that are interesting, but not that frequent. So just in terms of efficiency, it was fun, but I think I'm better off sticking to the stuff I was reading before, and then maybe later on steadily build up to that kind of level of reading. I've also found that reading stories is a lot more engaging for long periods of time than something like news. I really enjoy reading the news in Swedish each day, and it's one of the activities I really look forward to when I wake up. But for long periods of time, it's tough. I think especially because my articles are quite short, so you can kind of read 10, 20 articles within an hour, and it feels as though it's been a lot of time has elapsed, but it really hasn't. Reading a story, you kind of just get lost in it and go with the flow. So yeah, going forward, I want to do a lot more kind of long reading sessions with hopefully more and more books in the future. Overall, a great week with Link. That's the most I've read in a week by quite a large margin, and lots of fun, and it gives me a lot of confidence going into reading more in the future. This week on Netflix, I watched 12 episodes of the drama The Bonus Family, and as I've said in previous weeks, I really enjoy the show, and it was great to watch kind of a good amount in a condensed period of time. Similar to reading, I found that I'm noticing a lot more words while watching the show. I think this is because my vocabulary is broadening, and what that means is that on the screen at any one time, there's less and less new words. So if there is a new word, it stands out a lot more. And especially if it's repeated, I can kind of take a mental note of that keeps coming up. And sometimes I'm able to guess the word based on the context, or just kind of keep a mental note later on, and while I'm reading, I'll see it and then see the definition. And it's kind of really good having that that mental link between the two. And I think that will really help me remember those words long term. It's getting to the stage where it's just not a struggle to watch the show anymore. And I would say that it's like watching a show in English, but it definitely isn't, because there's scenes that kind of bring you back down to earth and remind you that your level's not brilliant. But at the same time, it's becoming really enjoyable, and you can kind of just watch the show and not really worry about it. I'm not really losing concentration, and I can keep kind of going through for the whole 45-minute episode. Another really positive sign is that my listening actually started to interfere with my reading of the subtitles, as I watched the show in Swedish, but with Swedish subtitles. And what I mean by that is, usually I can read the subtitles on the screen kind of at my own pace. They're usually on the screen for longer than they actually said, and that gives me a bit of leeway as to like my reading speed. But because my listening's actually passively getting better, I'm starting to tune in to the actual audio, and that makes it hard to ignore it. And obviously there's a bit of interference there, and it kind of throws me off a little bit. But that also means that my listening's improving, so it's tough at times, but I think that's definitely a positive sign going forward. And that gives me a lot of confidence for when I do more explicitly focus on listening in the future. But yeah, that's really encouraging. Overall, Netflix was great as always. It's always an amazing feeling being able to guilt-free watch something like Netflix, and the fact that it constitutes a study and it's actually helping me improve my Swedish. So yeah, no complaints there. I started using the textbook Complete Swedish, which I have used in the past, but very sporadically, and I covered the first 6 chapters. Before this week, I'd only ever got up to to chapter 5, so this is the furthest I've been with the book, and hopefully I can keep going forward with that. This is more of a supplementary resource. I'm still mainly focusing on reading and watching shows, but this is quite a good way to explicitly study the stuff that I've covered in the reading. I much prefer it that way around, because I kind of have covered everything and I've seen it in many contexts before through reading and through watching the show, and then I can kind of fill in bits and pieces and gaps in my knowledge through the textbook itself. I'm finding that the book is actually answering a lot of questions that I have while I'm reading or while I'm watching the show. Sometimes I'll see something like, why is it like that, or why is it not like that, and it's frustrating, but at the same time, I keep my head down, do the reading. But when I come to something like the textbook, it is answering my questions, so I'm thankful for that. I think I'm just going to go with this book quite slowly and steadily. Every now and again, do a chapter, progress further with it, but not stress too much about memorizing like conjugation tables by heart or anything like that. And really just enjoy it. Use it to fill in the gaps of my knowledge, rather than be the primary source and introduction to grammar patterns. I also introduced an Anki deck this week, and the deck that I chose was a 10,000 word sentence deck, and the primary exercise is essentially translating English into Swedish. The good thing about it is that it really put into practice kind of the passive knowledge I've learned through reading, into trying to figure out and piece together a sentence in Swedish. It's kind of like a bit of a artificial output in a sense, and it was fun but incredibly mentally taxing. I'm kind of having to really dive deep into my memory banks, trying to piece things together that I haven't even studied explicitly, and trying to kind of put together this complex puzzle. And it's definitely rewarding but very fatiguing at the same time. I surprised myself in being able to actually get a lot more correct than I thought I would, but I think it's a bit over-reliant on memorization. And this is great in the short term and it feels rewarding, but I don't think it's going to pay off that well in the future, at least for now. I think I introduced this a bit too early, and I think I'm going to put it on the back burner for a while, but I will come back to it. It's not the kind of deck I would create myself, but having a pre-made deck of 10,000 sentences is something that would take me an incredibly long time to make myself. And I think it will be rewarding, but I think it's just the wrong time, and my timing was just a bit off. Overall, a great week with both positives and negatives, and a lot of lessons learned, especially when it comes to sleep, and possibly other things that I'm not really considering as directly related to study, so diet, exercise, all that kind of stuff. So it's kind of food for thought going forward, and a great experiment nonetheless. That's about it for this week. If this challenge sounds fun and something you'd like to try, definitely give it a go. Also check out Language Come Up and Seabolt Speaks. Their channels will be down in the description. And yeah, thank you once again for watching. Hopefully I can see you next week for my January roundup and also my week 5 video. So see you next time, and yeah, thanks for watching. Bye for now.